ग्रीटिंग्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर पूर्वी ककरानी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोग्नोसी, ISF कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी. वी आर हियर टू स्टडी टिश्यू कल्चर ऑफ बनाना फॉर फील्ड प्लांटिंग. सो द एम ऑफ टूडेज एक्सपेरिमेंट रिमेन्स टू परफॉर्म टिश्यू कल्चर ऑफ बनाना फॉर फील्ड प्लांटिंग. The references that I have taken are from the textbook of industrial pharmacognosy, author Kalia sir. Then next is a plant biotechnology laboratory manual written by Anjana and Joy. Equipments required for today's experiment shall be laminar airflow cabinet and autoclave. The chemicals required must be fungicide, 70% ethanol, sterile distilled water, gentamicin antibiotic, and explant. Now, firstly, we shall see what is plant tissue culture. Plant tissue culture is a technique that is done in vitro and that is utilized to sustain or grow plant cells, tissues, or organs in sterile conditions on a nutrient culture medium of known composition. A whole new plant is regenerated from a single cell without cell walls, that is protoplast, single cells individually, whole single cells, stem, roots, shoots, nodes, pieces of leaves, all these can be used as explants, and the required nutrients and plant hormones are provided in the nutrient medium and a whole plant is regenerated. The tissue culture is performed in aseptic conditions under HEPA filter air provided in a laminar airflow cabinet. Now, there are four fundamental abilities of the plants that are utilized in plant tissue culture or that are exploited, we can say, for plant tissue culture. The first one of them is totipotency. The totipotency can be defined as the potential or inherent capacity of a plant cell to develop into an entire plant if suitably stimulated. It means a plant cell can be developed or exploited to regenerate a whole plant if given proper nutrient medium or hormones. That potential of the plant or plant cell is called totipotency. Second ability of the plant is dedifferentiation. This is a process in which tissues that have undergone cell differentiation, means the mature cells which cannot further divide, are made to reverse the process and become meristematic, or we can say primordial cell, and they start dividing again. This ability is called dedifferentiation. Third is competence. The endogenous potential of a given cell or tissue to develop in a particular way. That means simply the genetic ability or genetic code in a plant or a cell to grow in a particular manner or to reproduce in a particular manner is called the competency of the plant. And the fourth ability is the plasticity. Ability of the plant to adapt to environmental conditions. Whatever conditions that are given to the plant or plant cell for that matter, the cell or the plant adapts to that environmental conditions. Let it be climatic conditions, soil or without soil, or we can say water. All these conditions are utilized or the plant is adapted to it and starts regenerating. So these are the four fundamental abilities or the basis of plant tissue culture because of which the plant tissue culture is successful. Now the plant tissue culture medium that is required, because we are not growing the plant in soil, it is not a normal condition, so we need to give in vitro conditions or the nutrients that a plant gets from the soil. So what happens is, how do we prepare the plant tissue culture medium? In the first step, macronutrients and micronutrients are separately prepared in distilled water. and it is stirred well and then mixed. This is macronutrients, this is micronutrients, and they are mixed. Now, what are my macronutrients and micronutrients? There are inorganic nutrients that a plant requires. Macronutrients are the nutrients which are required in larger quantities, like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. These are six macronutrients that a plant requires. Then micronutrients which are required in less quantity but are essential, without which there may be deformity, or we can say that it cannot grow properly. They are in minute quantities but they are essential. Such micronutrients are iron, manganese, copper, then zinc, boron, chloride, etc. Then when these macronutrients and micronutrients are prepared in proper concentration, they are then mixed right in distilled water, a volume is made up. Then in the second step, all the other essential nutrients, like except macro and micro, there are other things also which are required, like growth hormones, amino acids, then sucrose, agar powder, it is the main, you can say, the medium in which all these nutrients are added, agar medium. All these things are added in the second step. Then, after adding all these nutrients one by one, in the third step, we make up the volume with distilled water. Then, the pH is adjusted. Now, according to the explant or the plant, pH requirement of each and every plant is different. That is a crucial step, and we have to adjust it using 1.1 normal NaOH or 0.1 normal HCl. If we need to basify the medium, we use 0.1 normal NaOH. If we want to acidify, then we use 0.1 normal HCl, right? Then, if the plant tissue culture medium is liquid, then no problem. If a solid medium is required, or we are preparing in the solid culture medium, then the agar-agar that we are using in the culture medium needs to be heated, right, to dissolve all the nutrients in that, because as it is being a solid, proper mixing is not possible without heating. So in the fifth step, we are heating if there is a requirement or there is a use of solid nutrient medium. Then these test tubes in the step 6, we can see equal volume of the nutrient medium is added to each and every test tube. And then in the seventh step, we are autoclaving. Autoclaving is done for sterilization of the plant tissue culture medium, right? If the nutrient medium or the growth hormones that we are using are heat labile, that means which get destroyed or degraded in the heat, because autoclave is ultimately giving heat, right? Heat, we are heating it up to 121 degree centigrade. So in that case, what we do is we do filter sterilization. So in autoclave, basically we are heating this plant tissue culture medium at 121 degree centigrade under 15 psi pressure. After sterilization, it is done for 30 to 40 minutes, right? After sterilization, it is taken out, it is allowed to cool down, and then it is used for further process. So an important step of plant tissue culture medium preparation is finished. Next step is sterilization. It is again a second important thing or step in plant tissue culture process. All the things that we are using for this experiment should be sterilized. Like starting from the explant to the means the glassware we are using, even for that matter knife or spatula or the plucker that we are using, then nutrient medium, as we saw, we have sterilized. Each and everything needs to be sterilized before getting to the final stage. राइट. सो फॉर ईच एंड एवरी इक्विपमेंट और ग्लासवेयर और एक्सप्लांट वट एवर कंपोनेंट वी आर यूजिंग इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट नीड्स अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ स्टेरिलाइजेशन टेक्निक. वॉट इट इज वी कैन सी द फर्स्ट फॉर न्यूट्रिएंट मीडियम वी आर यूजिंग ऑटोक्लेव राइट. वी सॉ इन द लास्ट स्टेप फॉर ऑटोक्लेविंग इट इज द स्टैंडर्ड टेम्परेचर ऑफ 120 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड इट इज द प्रेशर इज मेंटेन टू 15 PSI एंड इट इज डन फॉर 30 to 40 मिनट्स राइट. नाउ the glassware and the plastic ware we are using that are also autoclaved. Next, dry heat sterilization is applied to the instruments like scalpel, forceps, needles, all the pipettes plastic wares. Then when we are heading towards the procedure in which we are doing in laminar airflow hood, for in that one the scalpel and all the instruments that we are using is sterilized with the help of flame sterilization. Flame sterilization is simple. We take a burner and we just simply pass it through the flame of the burner. Then next is filter sterilization. I told you thermolabile substances, if they are present, they are present in the nutrient medium. We need to filter sterilize those substances or nutrient medium itself. Alcohol sterilization means it's simply hand sterilizer or hand sanitizer. Before doing any step further, we first sanitize our hands with 70% ethanol. As we are doing it in nowadays very much, we all know that, right? So especially in the laminar airflow hood, each and everything is sprayed with 70% alcohol, but you have to make sure that flame is off, the burner is off, right? You have to take care because alcohol is flammable. Then surface sterilization is done with explants. Surface sterilization is simply treatment of the explants with chemicals like sodium hypochlorite, hydrogen peroxide, mercury chloride. Now depending upon the explant, different types of chemicals are being used. How hard the explant is, like say for example if there is seed, so we can use strong chemical like hydrogen peroxide. If there is a leaf, soft parts of the plant are there, then we can use mild reagents like sodium hypochlorite, right? So a variety of reagents are used in surface sterilization. Even in surface sterilization, distilled water is also used. Now what exactly happens in plant tissue culture procedure? We take an explant. Right, explant can be, as I said, it can be a part of leaf, it can be a node, it can be a root, it can be seed, it can be embryo, any part of the plant can be taken, but for each and every plant, every part of the plant is not successful. Like say for example, today we are going to study the plant tissue culture of banana. So in that, even the part of the fruit is successfully cultured, right? Like this, for each and every plant or medicinal plant, there are specific explants that are studied and are successful. Each and every part of each and every plant is not always successful, right? So first we are taking the explant. We are sterilizing it, right? Surface sterilization is done very thoroughly. Then we are putting it in the liquid culture medium or solid culture medium for that matter. The culture medium preparation we have seen in the last slide. After putting this explant in the plant tissue culture medium, initiation stage occurs, means division of cells starts, that is initiation stage. Then multiplication stage number 2 is multiplication stage occurs, that is callus formation, undifferentiated cell mass. there is no fixed structure. You cannot determine which part of the plant it is. It is just a differentiated cell mass. Okay, so that means the plant tissue culture has started, right? In the next step, the definitive parts can be seen, which may take up to 21 to 30 days. But first root formation occurs and then shoot formation occurs, right? After this small seedlings are prepared, we transfer it to the greenhouse, right? So that suddenly the plant does not experience the climatic changes or soil changes. It may get infected, it may get degraded. So a controlled environment is provided, acclimatization is done, right? And in the last step, after acclimatization, if when this seedlings are or the saplings are successfully growing big, we can transfer it to the nurseries in the natural environment, right? This is basically what is happening in plant tissue culture, right? So the very crucial step, selection of the explant and sterilizing it and putting it in the culture medium, this is the very crucial step. Though each and every step is crucial, but this one is to be taken a good care of. Types of plant tissue culture. Callus culture, we have seen, each and every tissue culture experiences the first step as the formation of callus, undifferentiated, or you cannot make out which part of the plant it is. It is just a cell mass, unorganized cell mass. Suspension culture, in this the cells, individual cells or even protoplast is taken and it is suspended in liquid culture medium. Okay, then organ culture. In organ culture, as the name suggests, different organs of the plant are taken, like meristem culture, excised root culture. Meristem culture is the tip of shoot and root, which are fast growing cells. Such meristematic tissue is taken and it is planted in the plant tissue culture medium. Excised root culture, leaf culture, embryo culture, flower and floral meristem culture. In this, each and every part of the flower can be used as an explant. Ovary and ovule culture, cotyledon culture, whole cotyledon means the apart, like in dicotyledon, one cotyledon of the seed can be taken and it can wholly be used as explant. Anther and pollen culture. Then next is hairy root culture, protoplast culture, micropropagation, artificial seeds. Advantages of plant tissue culture. Advantage, the very first advantage is production of secondary metabolites within weeks. Even for the plants that are taking longer in the normal course for harvesting. The standard example for this is Texol, Texas brevifolia. Texas brevifolia gives us Texol after 100 years of its age. The component or the chemical constituent, phytoconstituent, is produced when the tree is 100 years old. And you know, averagely a person or a patient, we are using Texol in anti-cancer treatment, right? So, averagely a patient takes around 6 trees, or the amount of Texol produced by 6 trees to get treated, right? So, you can imagine how extinct or rather endangered species it is, right? Then next is the controlled culture conditions of cell culture techniques guarantee the constant quality of drug raw material. Uniformity, the major drawback of constituents or phytoconstituents is batch to batch variation in normal conditions. Now in tissue culture, we can control that. We can control the environmental conditions. we can control the climatic conditions, we can control the photo period means how much amount of light and how much amount of dark we can manipulate, right? Each and everything can be manipulated, and we can customize that how much or how a plant can give its chemical constituents in the maximum yield. We can customize those parameters, and uniformly we can give it to the plants so that a uniform amount of chemical constituents are produced, and not only uniform but maximum amount of chemical constituents are produced at a time and in each batch, right? Undesired byproducts can be bypassed, right? Plants from different climatic conditions. Now, according to geographical source also, the chemical constituents vary because of the climatic conditions or environmental factors. So that can be manipulated, that can be controlled in plant tissue culture medium. Many endangered and rare species produce unique medicinal plants. So that can be done in the plant tissue culture. Taxol can be quoted in this also, because so many plants of 100 years of age are very difficult to be found, right? That can be done in plant tissue culture in our own labs itself. Now, next advantage is many plants are or many secondary metabolites are so difficult to synthesize in laboratory that it is a necessity to rely on the natural resources. So many a times when there are natural products that are in less quantity, what we do is we semi-synthesize it in our labs. Semi-synthetic products are produced, right? So that we do not have to rely upon the natural sources. But sometimes those products or semi-synthesis is not possible, right? We have to rely on the natural sources only. So in that case, we can take advantage of plant tissue culture. It is capable of producing novel metabolites. Many a times what happens is manipulating the growth hormones or manipulating the nutrient in the liquid culture medium produces such novel metabolites that are not naturally seen in the plants growing in soil, right? It happens sometimes. Used for biotransformation like hydrogenation, dehydrogenation, isomerization, hydroxylation, opening of rings and glycosylation. These biotransformation steps that cannot be replicated in the lab can be taken use of in plant tissue culture. Then helpful in tracing biosynthetic pathway, tracer technique, which we have studied. In tracer technique, what we do is we label the precursor and see what changes or what biosynthetic changes are happening and what product is finally being produced. That can be observed or that can be seen in plant tissue culture medium. Next advantage is it gives the plants that have the ability to grow throughout the year irrespective of the season, right? A large space can be avoided. Plant tissue culture can be done in, you can see, even in a test tube. So very less space is required. The naturally occurring plants or their metabolites cannot be patented as such. We know that natural discoveries cannot be patented. So doing a plant tissue culture gives us the right to patent. So today's experiment is banana tissue culture. What we are doing exactly in this tissue culture, what explant we are taking, we will be seeing here. So part of the experiment is done outside the laminar airflow unit or cabinet, and planting our explant in tissue culture medium is done strictly in laminar airflow in HEPA filter, right? So firstly we are taking or preparing explant. Now there are two techniques or two explants that can be taken in case of banana. First is sucker, right? Sucker, or second is the fruit, right? Fruit can be taken. So banana sucker is cut and the size is minimized to this level. Very small size of banana sucker is prepared. Then it is washed in tap water for 30 minutes. Now the step of surface sterilization starts here. Surface sterilization means sterilization of explant, right? So the surface sterilization consists of three steps. The very first step is washing the explant in the simple tap water or running tap water for 30 minutes. In the next, we are using soap solution. We are washing the explant in the soap solution for 30 minutes. Then in the third step, it is treated with the fungicide, right? To avoid the fungus development in the tissue culture medium. The fungicide used in this case is bevacizumab, combination of bevacizumab, Indofil and SAAF for 30 minutes, right? We have to keep this explant in the fungicide for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, take it out and we have to wash it using distilled water. After distilled water, we shall take this explant. The explant is ready now. So we will be going in the laminar airflow cabinet in class 100 chamber or cabin, where we shall transfer this explant to a sterile bottle. Right, sterile bottle. The bottle is sterilized using autoclave. Then wash it for 2 minutes in 70% alcohol in the explant. Then next final wash with the sterile water is done. Then 0.1% mercuric chloride is treated to the explant with continuous shaking for 5 minutes. And finally, after shaking this, a final wash with sterile water is given. Now a uniform size of the explant is maintained in the final step. The size is decided, or the size is made up to 8 by 8 by 10 mm, right? And as we can see in the picture, it is then planted in or inoculated in the plant tissue culture medium, and it is allowed to remain there for multiplication or formation of callus. This may take up to 7 to 10 days, right? After this, we can see the initiation stage after 7 to 10 days. Then after 2 weeks, we can see the formation of callus culture, and around after 30 days, we can see a proper formation of roots has started. This is the schematic of what we have done in plant tissue or banana tissue culture. This is second explant, as I told you. The second explant is the shoot apex or meristematic region of the shoot, and then it is cut into a very small piece of, as I told you, 8 by 8 by 10 mm, and then it is planted in liquid tissue culture medium, and then we can see the formation of callus, and after callus, sapling or plantlet is formed, and then we can transfer it to the acclimatization chamber or greenhouse. Result: this is the already performed experiment taken from the already published literature. This is the explant, right? Explant is taken, sucker, this is sucker, the first explant that we had seen, sucker, and then this sucker is sterilized in this picture A, and then in the next step it is inoculated in the plant tissue culture medium. After some days, we can see इनिशिएशन और द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द सेल मास, देन शूट्स आर सीन, रूट्स आर सीन, राइट, शूट्स एंड रूट्स कैन बी सीन क्लियरली इन दिस पिक्चर नंबर 9. दिस इज द सैपलिंग रेडी फॉर ट्रांसफर इन द ग्रीन हाउस. दिस इज द ग्रीन हाउस इन विच इट इज placed or planted, and then finally after properly growing we are shifting it to the fields or nursery. Thank you for having patience.